The game begins in 3, 2, 1.
Welcome back to CBS Mornings. We've got an important and heartbreaking story to show you now. It involves children and their families going hungry in the East African nation of Somalia. Welcome back to CBS Mornings. We've got an important and heartbreaking story to show you now. It involves children and their families going hungry in the East African nation of Somalia. Now we're going to turn to Iran, where protests against the Islamic regime have been going on for weeks now. The government is still trying to crack down. Now we're going to turn to Iran, where protests against the Islamic regime have been going on for weeks now. The government is still trying to crack down. Russia's war on Ukraine dominated today's G20 summit talks. President Biden is meeting with other world leaders in Indonesia.
Thank you, Tim. 6:51, we're revisiting Blair's Social Second. Of course, St. Louis area tradition is for you all to ask the kids for a joke. So I asked you this morning if you do ask for that in exchange for candy, and what are some of the best ones you have heard? This was all new to me. I hadn't heard of this tradition until I came here to St. Louis. So Mariana, good morning to you. Mariana says, I asked for the joke. The little boy, no more than 4 or 5, said, the Rams. I gave him several pieces of candy. So he's learning the story at a very, very young age. We also heard from Michelle, and she said, no, some kids are too shy. If they have a joke, they will usually say, do you want to hear a joke? I just want it to be fun for them. And I did see a lot of comments saying that some of the kids were shy, and some people used to just walk away if they asked for a joke because they just were too shy to even do it. So she says no, she just wants them to have a good time. And then we heard from Kayla. Good morning to you, Kayla. Thank you for participating. She said, what are two witches who live together called? Broommates. Yes. So we got a lot of jokes there for you on our Facebook page. We want to hear the favorite ones. We also have some on our website if your kiddos need some examples of jokes, some ideas when they go out trick-or-treating today. So you can make sure to stay tuned in to Facebook. And our website, fox2now.com, ahead of this Halloween. And we'll be right back at 6:53 on the dot, 56 degrees.
Trying to invoke Terry Lynn Allen.
Business with a smile. The warm attitudes. Cool when you're rude. Sweet when she greets ya. You're wrong, she'll dismiss ya. With such style and such grace, she brings class to the place. When she walks through the room, you have to assume that she's a
business with a smile, the warm attitudes, cool when you're
always having fun, those two. All right, we're revisiting Blair's social second. I told you millennials, Gen Zers, they're experiencing some debt while they're looking for love, trying to find the right one. They're paying too much money for these dates, right? So I asked you all, have you ever gone into debt while dating, and how do you budget your outing? So we heard from a few of you all. Donna Dryden, good morning to you, Donna. Thank you for participating. She said, I've been married for 29 years. We spent minimal money on dating, and in 9 months, we bought our house. Maybe young adults do not have the same focus as we did. So then you have the young adults kind of responding to that and saying, hey, stuff was probably cheaper back then. That's what they had to say. This was one of the responses to the one I just showed you, Mickey Delgado. He said, imagine being a teenager and it takes over an hour's pay just to grab McDonald's. He said, you can easily spend $100 on the cheaper side of a night out now. So Mickey saying, hey, stuff is just costing more for us. Applebee's for about $45 when it's all said and done, and easily $40 at a movie theater. So, yeah, you're going to spend some cash out there. Then we heard from Dennis Westbrook. Good morning to you, Dennis. Thank you for your participation. He said, I've never gone into debt from a date, and that's ridiculous. Set aside a certain amount, plan your date, don't go over budget. That's simple. But what if the woman starts, you know, ordering stuff up? How do you really control that? I don't know. Don't get that. That's too much. That's out of the budget. We want to hear from you guys. Go to our Facebook page, Fox 2 Now. Let us know what you think. 653, it is 64 degrees. Stick with us. We'll be right back.
Hello, everyone. The wait is over. It's finally here. Season 4 of The Family Business on BET Plus. Watch it tonight. I will be watching. See you there.
Sister, sister, girl, this song's for you. Changes we've been through. I hear your laughter, and girl, I share your pain. 'Cause the heart of every woman is the same. Now, what makes us different? Sister, sister, girl.
We're in Houston tonight at Soundcheck right now. Hometown. Yay, I'm so excited. All right. Hope to see y'all here tonight. Bye. We're in Houston tonight at Soundcheck right now. Hometown. Yay, I'm so excited. All right. Hope to see y'all here tonight. Bye. We're in Houston tonight at Soundcheck right now. Hometown. Yay, I'm so excited. All right. Hope to see y'all here tonight. Bye.
All right, we're going to revisit Blair's social second. We told you that trending right now, The Bachelorette and 90 Day Fiancé. So these are your dating shows. Plenty of them out there. A lot of people like to binge. Really toxic, but hey, we like them. They've been around for a long time. We asked you all if you would go on a dating show to find love, right? Okay, well, we heard from a few of you. Christy Mock, she said, never. For one, I'm married, but even if I was single, there is no way. These shows are all scripted and a complete joke. We also heard from Patty Chambers. She said, no, they are both ridiculous. Those people are only looking for 15 minutes of fame. Margie and I were talking about, you know, how genuine these shows really are. Either way, still entertaining. And then the last response we got, a little more positive about this. I would give it a shot, haven't had the best of luck anyway. Some of my past dates, I swear I was on funniest dating videos. So Nella, good morning to you. Thank you for responding. We want to know what you think. Go to our Facebook page, Fox 2 Now. Let us know if you would go on a dating show looking for love.
Hey, everybody. So we are in Vancouver, Canada tonight. We had a show. We just got in, and let me tell you, it was fire. Everybody was lit. We had a great time. The event was called Music Heals, and it does. And I think we all got some healing tonight. We had a great time. So I just wanted to sign on and tell everyone who came out tonight in Vancouver, Canada, to our show, God bless. You guys take care. And thank you so much for coming out to party with us. So until next time, bye.
I literally feel naked without my keys. You know, this is better than gold. This is gold. I don't care what nobody say. You can't tell me this is not a platinum diamond chain. Because you know what? I walked right through those doors and I got sober. I've connected with my siblings. I have connected with my children. I have mentally and emotionally connected back with myself, which is very important. Home is everything.
If you can't do that, then I'll find someone who can.
I don't wanna wait till tomorrow.
I can't wait
till you know. And this feeling is so strong.
And it's so strong.
I don't wanna wait till tomorrow.
Three people are dead following a school shooting in St. Louis, Missouri. Authorities say a 19-year-old walked into Central Visual and Performing Arts High School and opened fire.
The individual had almost a dozen 30-round, you know, high-capacity magazines on him.
Killed inside the school were a 16-year-old girl and a teacher. The teacher, Jean Kirk Kuchka, was a mother of five. The alleged gunman, police say, graduated from the school last year. Authorities say the suspect died at the hospital after exchanging gunfire with police. Seven security personnel were reportedly on duty at the school during the time of the incident.
It could have been a whole lot worse.
Beyond the two fatalities, police say at least seven other students, aged 15 and 16 years old, were taken to the hospital for gunshot wounds or injuries. As the community mourns, officials say they do not have a motive. This shooting is still under investigation. This is Inside Edition Digital.
Margie, well, right now the All-Star Game is top trending on Twitter in the St. Louis area. We asked you why you think the National League struggles to take the win. It's been almost a decade now. So we heard from a few of you all. Russell English, good morning to you. He said NL pulled their good players too fast. Let them play a few more innings. AL knows how to keep their studs in the game. A lot of people are saying that same thing. Jim Summer said it's 100% coaching. Who pulls their best player and cleanup hitter after one at bat? No one. Mm. And then good morning to you, Sandy Clement. She said, I enjoyed seeing the smiles on their faces. Why not just have fun out there? However, the score is now 46-43. So that's what you guys have to say. We want to know what you think has to happen for them to pull through. Go to our Facebook page, Fox 2 Now, and continue to leave your comments there. We'll be right back. Stick with us. It is 6:54. Thank you, Amelia. 6:52, revisiting Blair's Social Second. We told you live Christmas tree prices are up, and we asked if you would be willing to pay 5 to 10% more or just go artificial. So we heard from a few of you all this morning. First up, Kendra. Good morning to you, Kendra. She said, I will pay the price to keep a real tree. It's worth it to keep the tradition of picking it out, and the cat prefers it too, so you got to make sure that the cat is pleased for Christmas. Then we heard from Debbie. She says, I enjoy our artificial tree more than a real tree. I can have the Christmas tree up longer without the cleanup. And that's what I was saying to John earlier. You don't have to clean up when you have that artificial tree. And then we heard from Andrea. Good morning to you. She said, we always buy a live tree that we plant in our backyard after Christmas is over. Prices won't stop us from doing the same thing this year. So a lot of you all were just saying you would like to keep that tradition going and you prefer to just get a live tree. They are around $200 this year, they say, in that survey. So we would like to hear from you all. Go to our Facebook page, Fox 2 Now, and let us know what you think. It is 6:53, 31 degrees.
Say the words you long to hear. I'm in love with you. Ooh. Listen. Do you want to know a secret? That you tell, oh, closer. Let me whisper in your ear. Say the words you long to hear. Say the words you long to hear. I'm in love with you. Ooh. Listen. Do you want to know a secret? Promise that you tell. Oh, closer. Let me whisper in your ear. Say the words you long to hear. Say the words you long to hear. I'm in love with you. Ooh. Listen. Do you want to know a secret? Promise that you tell. Oh, closer. Let me whisper in your ear.
All right. Thank you so much, Tim. Going to check back in with him. 6:53 right now. We're revisiting Blair's Social Second. We told you guys that it's going to get cold again soon. It's going to be chili season. There's an opportunity with Bush Beans to become a chili commissioner if you got a good recipe. Right. So I asked you all, what is your recipe for the chili? And do you like beans in your chili or no beans? So we heard from a lot of you. Most of you said you like beans. Okay. That's just first off. Tuki Carlson, good morning to you. She said, I make a mean spicy bourbon chili that has no beans, but my husband, Chris, has its own secret spicy chili that does have beans. We love both. Love that both of you guys are cooking in the house, too. That's a good thing.
Right.
Chris Straub, good morning to you, Chris. Thank you for chatting with us. He said ground deer, pork sausage, beans, onions, peppers, and tomatoes with cornbread on the side. Got to have the cornbread on the side. John said he likes that as well. And then lastly, we heard from Kianda. Good morning to you. Thank you for chatting with us. She said, it really doesn't matter as long as it's made from scratch. You can't be mixing canned chili in and calling it the best. So she says you need to do the real thing in order to have a really good chili. That season is coming, guys. It's going to cool off and get back cold at some point. We want to hear from you guys. How do you make your chili? And do you leave the beans in or out? Go to our Facebook page, Fox 2 Now, and keep chatting with us. We'll be right back. It is 69 degrees. Stick with us.
Climb aboard, Brother Jay, cause the Roller Derby Express is on its way.
It can't be, not tonight.
Oh, Lord, Thelma.
Hey, look here. If you were a socket and I was a light, could we get together and twinkle tonight?
Now, Papa, if you were a shoe.
Yeah.
And I were a sock.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I say?
Yeah.
Go crawl under a rock.
Hey, Thelma.
Never.
She's starting to weaken. Ooh, Thelma. Girl, where you been hiding yourself? You got to be the foxiest chick there ever was. Just say the word and I'm yours forever.
No.
In celebration of our 30th anniversary of our Funky Divas album, we are giving away 30 free all-access passes to the global event at HitCore. In celebration of our 30th anniversary of our Funky Divas album, we are giving away 30 free all-access passes to the global event at HitCore.
Blair. Thank you, Margie. Well, we're revisiting Blair's social second. Now, we told you that the Batman suit worn by George Clooney is up for grabs. It is going up for auction, and it's expected to start off at $40,000. So we asked you, do you love anything that much to where you would pay those big bucks for that? So we heard from a couple of you. Kim Hendon, she said, I pay for Harry Potter props. So she's right along with Amelia on that, a big Harry Potter fan. Then we heard from Jason Lewis. Good morning to you, Jason. Jason said, can't take it with you when you die. No point in worshiping idols. So Jason wouldn't be on board with buying anything like that. Then we heard from Robert. Good morning to you, Robert. He said, if I had that kind of disposable income, I would definitely buy the Keaton or Nolan Batman suit. But the Clooney suit, he said, oh, heck no. That suit had some extra additions to it. So he said that wouldn't be the one that he would buy. We want to know what you guys think. Go to our Facebook page, Fox 2 Now, and let us know if you would spend some big bucks for some props. We'll be right back. Stick with us.
Birthday. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Why you hiding back there? Why you hiding?
Happy birthday.
Yeah.
Revisit Blair Social Second. We are telling you, may the 4th be with you. This is for all of our Star Wars fans. We asked you who your favorite character is and perhaps your favorite movie or TV show. So here's what you guys had to say. Jeffrey Jones said, Darth Vader, tragic character who falls yet still redeems himself. The best movie in the collection is The Empire Strikes Back, hands down. All right, we heard from someone else too. Marvin Hogg, good morning to you. Thank you so much for participating. Lando, no doubt. Lando has more cool and swagger than Solo ever did. The fact that he was played by Billy Dee Williams and then Donald Glover definitely helped. So you guys, all the Star Wars fans, have a good time today. Get caught up on all of those movies and revisit them. Thank you so much. That was Blair Social Second. We'll be right back after the break.
My favorite song, Southern Girl.
Let's leave today. What?
Super cool there. We're going to revisit Blair's Social Second. We told you even McDonald's was taking away their dollar promotion where you could buy any size drink for just a buck. So we asked you, what are some of your favorite things that are no longer the same price as they used to be for a long, long time? So we're revisiting Blair's Social Second. Sarah Kivett, good morning to you. Thank you for participating. She said all of the favorite things we buy and coffee. We buy whatever is the cheapest, not our name brands. All right, and we also heard from Jackie Roberts. Jackie said, every item I buy, Dollar Tree. They even went up by 25% on every item in the store. Now, you know Dollar Tree, everything's supposed to be a dollar, so that's just not right. All right, and the last one was from Renee Anderson. She said, this is the first time in my life of 71 years that I've witnessed a huge escalation of prices in a very short period of time. It's very frightening. I like to hear some wisdom from people. She's been around for a long time now. She's 71 years old. So thank you so much for participating, Renee. My favorite thing is the Mani Pedi. That's way up now. I'm gonna spend $100 to go get that done. So we wanna hear from you guys. Go to our Facebook page, Fox 2 Now, and let us know what you think. We'll be right back, 6:54.
And everyone here made the same mistakes as me.
Say, baby. Say hello to Mr. J.
Did you notice anything unusual about Henry the maintenance man?
Yeah, he was wet. I guess the man sweats a lot.
Yeah, and this time he certainly had a lot of help. Did you do it?
Do what?
You know what? Henry was hit from above with a bag full of water.
No.
even ask, I'm not him. I've never been him. I can't even stand the little creep.
The name's Jenkins. Cupid Jenkins. I'll return your page, doll.
You really Cupid?
Oh, you just used to having little people with wings materialize in your apartment every night.
Leaders. This included Lena Horne, this included Dick Gregory, and this included comedians, comics, trumpet players, baseball players. Show me in the white community where a comedian is a white leader. Show me in the white community where a singer is a white leader, or a dancer or a trumpet player is a white leader. These aren't leaders. These are puppets and clowns.
I know you sense we got a little Christmas spirit going today. We're going to begin this hour with the undeniable queen of Christmas music, the one and only Mariah Carey. I know you sense we got a little Christmas spirit going today. We're going to begin this hour with the undeniable queen of Christmas music, the one and only Mariah Carey. We are so excited to announce first on CBS Mornings that Mariah Carey will be gifting us with yet another Christmas special. It's going to be called Mariah Carey, Merry Christmas to All, and will be filmed at her upcoming Christmas shows at Madison Square Garden. Cool. We're happy to say you can watch that special on December 20th right here on CBS. I like to say she's a diva in the best of ways. You know, she's very confident. She's very happy. She's at a good place in her life. You know, and Christmas, she says, she wants to give her kids a Christmas that she never had.
Yeah.
You know, she had some bumps and bruises growing up along the way. But we were sitting in the hallway of her apartment. Even the hallway looks great.
I know, it looks fabulous.
Even the hallway looks
I'd live there in that hallway.
Nice. She gave us a lot of time.
I love the fact that she talks about being a songwriter,
yes.
Which I don't think that people sometimes...
But that's more important to her.
Right, that's more important. Because wasn't I telling you, Tony, that there are people, I believe, in pop and in rock music that are either you love the lyrics or you love the beat and the music, and I'm a lyrics guy. I love when I hear and see beautiful lyrics that are poetic and they're set to music. I'm into that, so I applaud her.
Yeah, as great as her voice is, she's most proud of what she does when she takes a pen and starts writing songs.
Yeah, she can really write. I love the words of wisdom on when does the Christmas season begin.
Yes.
Gotta get through Thanksgiving.
Thanksgiving. This
makes
whole
sense
thing,
to me.
Yeah, that whole thing about it, time, it, she said that's just a fun thing she does with Ryan. Yeah, yeah. It started with Ryan. She believes after Thanksgiving.
Yeah.
And I love books that are written by people like Mariah Carey that talk about their childhood so that it provides a path for other young kids.
Yep.
If I had a book like that as a kid, who knows?
But is she the queen of Christmas? What does Mrs. Claus think of that?
Thank you.
Jenkins. All right. One, two, you know what to do. Down at the Bijou, he was a fan. Dollar's head was brand renowned. She's all the movies, whatever plays.
Two times nightly and matinee.
Well, Tom is famous, you hear. He comes on strong with the ladies I knew. Now he's got class and he's got clout.
Come on, mama, we stepping out.
Welcome back to CBS Mornings. A political newcomer made history in the governor's race in Maryland. His name is Wes. Welcome back to CBS Mornings. A political newcomer made history in the governor's race in Maryland. His name is Wes.
Sister Ava is partly responsible for these study guides. Sometimes. I don't know whether you understand exactly what I'm about to say, but you know, there are certain people who have a certain chemistry that allow you to create. Sister Ava has the kind of spiritual chemistry that causes her to love the word of Allah. She loves Master Farad Muhammad. She loves the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. She loves the work of Islam. And because of that love, there's a chemistry that allows me absolutely to create. That's, I guess, the best word I can use. Because this material flowed as though you turned on a faucet. And it just came without a lot of thought, preparation, or study. It came from the inside out based upon my study of the words and teachings of the Honorable.
Hey, everybody, we're in Vogue. Join us for the Houston Magic Under the Stars event at the Cynthia Woods Mitchell Pavilion, November 5th. See you there. Hey, everybody, we're in Vogue. Join us for the Houston Magic Under the Stars event at the Cynthia Woods Mitchell Pavilion, November 5th. See you there. Hey, everybody, we're in Vogue. Join us for the Houston Magic Under the Stars event at the Cynthia Woods Mitchell Pavilion, November 5th. See you there. Hey, everybody, we're in Vogue. Join us for the Houston Magic Under the Stars event at the Cynthia Woods Mitchell Pavilion, November 5th. See you there.
God's sakes, what did I do to you to make you keep on?
So much time. Bitch, I'm stylish. Glock talk, big t-shirt, Billy Eilish. Watch on my wrist, but I want that diamond. Niggas talk crazy when I pull up in silent. Mile high, bring that shit back, bitch, I'm stylish.
Wanna be a boy, you wanna be.
The game begins in 3, 2, 1.